Hi everyone. In the today's lecture, I am going to deal with the concept of theory of chromatography. What exactly the theory of chromatography is, says you that how the separation process progress from the initial stage to final stage. So in this theory, you need to know there are two systems. One is continuous chromatographic system. One is a complete chromatographic system. What do you mean by continuous chromatography? Suppose if you take HPLC, the run goes on doing with the time. Whereas the complete chromatography, suppose if you take the TLC or any paper chromatography where the chromatography completes within short time. So there where you find the RF value as rate of movement of solute by rate of movement of solvent front, you will get the values. So this is the fundamental information. This is for complete chromatography. Now we are going to see the theory of chromatography with respect to continuous chromatography. So how it works? First and foremost thing is you have a stationary phase, that is your column of interest, and you have your, this is column. The column is packed with stationary phases. So you have a different stationary phase. Again, you have C8, C18, silica, alumina, chiral, pellicular. So there are different types of stationary phases. I am not going to deal with those things here. I am going to deal with the theory of chromatography. Now you have a mobile phase. That is, for example, I take acetonitrile and water. Now I am passing these two in the ratio of 80:20. Okay, up to this you understood. Now this is my pump. This pump will suck the solvent, mobile phase, and pass on to the column. So now this is my injection port, where I am injecting using my Hamilton syringe. Where I am injecting my compound. Suppose, assume that I am injecting a compound, caffeine. So now what happens in the chromatography is the rate at which the compound present in the mobile phase or it is present in the stationary phase. This is the fundamental information in the complete chromatography. For that, you have a term called as RF value. So what is RF value? Let us see in our next explanation. So you should always remember that the concentration of analyte in the mobile phase and in the concentration of analyte in the stationary phase, that will tells you your complete chromatography system. Now RF is your retardation factor. Suppose if your compound is having 100% retardation factor, that means it's completely retarded. What is retardation? That means retardation is prevention of analyte to go into stationary phase. So there is no analyte gone into stationary phase. Now whatever the result you get is the analyte pass from the voids, not into the stationary phase. This is the fundamental information. If suppose the retardation factor is less, so the analyte goes into the stationary phase, So this is the fundamental difference between the RF. Let us see what exactly the RF tells you. So let us see in an exponential form. So RF is equal to retardation factor is equal to Vm into Cm. That means the concentration of analyte in the mobile phase and volume of analyte in the mobile phase. So this is the fundamental information which when the mobile phase is passing. Suppose it goes into the column. Suppose if you do not have any of the partitioning into the stationary phase, in the column also you have only the volume of mobile phase and concentration of analyte in the mobile phase. Only these two components you have. However, if there is certain partitioning into the stationary phase, you have an another factor called as volume of stationary phase and concentration of stationary phase. So by this, what you understand is, if the compound is passing through the stationary phase, your concentration of analyte is in two parts. What is, one is in your mobile phase component and another in is your stationary phase component. Suppose if your analyte is only in mobile phase, this is termed as Vm into Cm. Fundamental information. Now just divide the portion with your Cm, which is common in both the terms. So I am dividing this term. Now I will get a formula, that is RF is equal to Vm divided by Vm plus, now this fraction I will treat as K, that is K into Vs. So this is the fundamental definition of retardation factor, where K is your distribution coefficient. Now what is K here? K is equal to Cs by Cm. This is the distribution coefficient of analyte in stationary phase and mobile phase. This is the fundamental information. Let us see. Now we will start with this one and we will further check the other equation. Now what was the last equation? RF is equal to Vm by Vm plus K into Vs. This was the equation where K stand for Vm by Cm. So this is the fundamental information which we are getting. Okay, now we will divide the equation with Vm. So I'll divide the equation with Vm. So let us see what I will get. So RF is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus K into 1 by 1 plus K into Vs by Vm, or I can even write RF is equal to 1 by 1 plus K dash. Now K dash is your capacity factor. So earlier we see K is your distribution coefficient and now K dash is your capacity factor. Now one thing which you identify, the efficiency of column depends upon K and K dash. Now K and K dash are both are proportional to each other. So it will tell you the fraction of analyte present in the mobile phase and fraction of analyte present in the stationary phase. Let us see further how it tells you. Suppose you have a chromatographic system. Say you have a graph like this and you have your analyte coming out at certain retention time. Now up to now we have seen RF, that is retardation factor. Now we are seeing a fraction called as RT, that is retention time, that is the time of injection and the time of inflection point. Suppose you have a 100% retardation factor. So there is no component goes into the particles of the stationary phase. However, suppose this is your stationary phase. If none of the component goes into the stationary phase, but however, the analyte goes into the voids of the stationary phase. So that this will give you void volume. Suppose you got a signal at somewhere that is T0, that means this is the value of unretained compound. This will tell you the void volume of the column. This is the fundamental information. Now, what are the factors affecting the retention time? The retention time, the factor affecting the retention time is, one is your flow rate and another one is your length of the column. So how it affects, let us see. Simple thing, if you know the simple mathematical or physical formula, that is distance is equal to velocity into time. Now the rate at which the mobile phase is passing into the column depends upon mu into RF, that is mu is equal to here, that is the speed at which the mobile phase is flowing, that is generally mentioned in centimeters per second, and here the RF is your again retardation factor. Now here again you should understand one thing. This is the, it is flowing throughout the column. So here the again the rate is equal to L by mu into RF. But with respect to our earlier equation, RF is equal to 1 by 1 plus K star. By substituting that into this formula, that is L by U into RF, now I will subtract the value of RF here, that is into 1 by 1 plus K star, so that will come around 1 plus K star. So up to this, you understood. Now, I can even write the equation in this fashion, that is L by U into T0 into 1 plus K star. Why I am writing T0? That is the time of elution of unretained compound. So this is negligible, that's why I am writing into this value. This will tell you the retention time of any of the component. This is the fundamental information, what exactly you are seeing. Further, the rate of elution of your compound, that is the chromatogram onto a column, that is suppose you are getting an RF value of RT value of around 10, that is time of elution. Now it is also depends upon volume of mobile phase, and again volume of mobile phase and RF, that is retardation factor. Now if I see in this fashion how much amount of mobile phase is required for separation, now the volume of mobile I will do, that is Vm into RF, that is retardation time, retention time is equal to Vm into RF. So now I know Vm, now the RF is equal to 1 plus K star. Now if I multiply this, Vm plus K star. Now what is K? K star, I know that K star is equal to K into Vs by, K into Vs by Vm, I am right. K into Vs by Vm. Now K star, Vm plus what is K star? Now I will substitute the K star by my earlier equation, that is K into Vs by Vm. So however my Vm, so it gets cancelled. So now I'll get finally Vm plus K into Vs. This is the final equation. So what it tells me that the complete retention time depends upon volume of analyte plus distribution of analyte in stationary phase, volume of stationary phase, and K is your distribution coefficient, how well it is distributed in the stationary phase and how well is it distributed in the mobile phase. This is the fundamental information which tells you how to characterize a chromatographic system. Now, the classical definition of chromatographic system was given by two groups. One group is called as Martin and Synge. Martin and Synge. And the other is your Giddings group. So, according to Martin and Synge, the entire chromatographic process is divided into number of plates. So, more the number of plates, more is the resolution. This is the fundamental information by Martin and Synge. Whereas, Giddings suggests that the chromatographic system is depends upon the rate theory. So, this is the fundamental information of what the theory of chromatography till now we have learned. Now, let us see the concepts of resolution and number of theoretical plates. Suppose you have a chromatographic system where your analyte has been separated properly. Now, this is your mean of, that is point of inflection, that is the absorption maximum, that is suppose if your concentration, retention time, not concentration, that is retention time versus absorbance. If you see, this is the HPLC general pattern. Now, if you draw the tangent towards the mean, if you draw tangents towards the mean, at the maximum value, you have a mean of sigma. At half width, you have a 2 sigma value. And at the base, you have a 4 sigma value. Now, why we are taking this sigmoidal pattern is, when you are doing your analysis, the retention time is generally not constant. So why? Because of the change in the mobile phase, the change in the temperature conditions, and the change in the operator, or there are several factors why your retention time is not constant. That's why we use a term called as relative retention time. So where we use the term called as these sigmoidal values. And further, the efficiency of the column depends upon length of the column, that is how fast it is eluting, how much length it is, as well as number of theoretical plates and height equal to theoretical plates. Suppose if your height equivalent to theoretical plate is defined as L by N, that is L is your length of the column, N is the number of theoretical plates. So this is the fundamental information of your chromatography. Now, how you will characterize the efficiency of your column system? The efficiency of column system is given by formulas, that is N, that is number of theoretical plate, is equal to 16 into TR, that is retention time, by width at the base whole square, N is equal to 5.534 into retention time by width at the half height whole square. Now, this value of 16 you are getting because we are taking the sigma value at the base, and you are getting a value of 5.534 because that is we are taking at the value at the half height. Width at the half height. This is the fundamental difference. And when to take width at the base and when to take width at the half height depends upon how well your chromatogram is resolved. Let us see the resolution of chromatogram. That is separation. Suppose if you have a chromatogram which is perfectly separated, then in this case you should always take width at half height. Suppose if your chromatogram is not well separated at half height, it has some tailing signal. Now in these cases you will take the width at the base. This is the fundamental information. Now, what is alpha? Now, alpha is a separation factor. Suppose if you have two analytes in your analysis, one is analyte 1, analyte 2. If these two are well separated, with their base, that separation is called as proper separation. That is, alpha separation is equal to TR2, that is retention time 2, retention time 1, that is TR2 minus TR1 divided by TR1, sorry, TR1 is TR0, that is unretained peak. TR2 minus TR0 by TR1 minus TR0. That means the difference from the retention time to the retained peak and unretained peak divided by the retention time of another retained peak and unretained peak. This will tell you the alpha, that is separation factor. This is the fundamental information, how well the compounds are separated. Now what is resolution? Resolution, earlier cases the resolution was defined at the how well they are separated from the baseline. However, let us see one chromatogram. If you see this chromatogram, so here this base and this base have been well separated, but there is no resolution because the tailing of one signal is interacting with the fronting of another signal. So this is not well separation. To get well separation, you should always remember that your signal should be well resolved. So how, what do you mean by well resolved? It should be well resolved for the base, and there should be no interaction with any of the signal. So this is called as well resolved signal. So now what is the parameter which will tell you the proper resolution is? Again, you have an equation, that is 2 into TR2 minus TR1 divided by W2 plus W1, that is retention time of the signal minus retention time of the first signal divided by whole width of the total signal. This will give you the resolution factor. Further, you have one more equation, that is that which tells you around resolution is n, number of theoretical plate is equal to n by 4 into alpha minus 1 by alpha into k star by k star plus 1. So this is the fundamental equation. So here n is number of theoretical plates, alpha is your separation factor, and k star is your capacity factor. This is the fundamental information of your complete chromatographic picture. So you should be well defined what is chromatography, what is retardation factor, what is retention time, what is void volume, what is a diffusion coefficient, what is capacity factor, what is separation, when you will take width at the half height, when you will take the width at the base, what is resolution, what is separation, what is the concentration of analyte in the mobile phase, what is the concentration of analyte in both mobile phase and stationary phase. These are the fundamental information which you need to know before starting analysis of any of the chromatographic system. So thank you. In the next class, we will see the validation of HPLC instrument. If you like my lectures, please subscribe and share among your friends. Thank you.